Scott, part two. Okay. So in part one, you had some homework to do and you sent it through to me. So let's have a look at that now. This is my file. This is what I sent you. And it got us to sort of this point. And in your file is looking good. Input RE. Did I input RE? Regular expression. Interesting. What's he doing? Okay. Let's just give this bad boy a run. Ba-boom, boom, boom. Everything's still working, I hope. Cool. Don't even need that, really. All right, so listing equals superfind all div class vehicle listing used. Now, if we do recall, and let's just jump on the website to make sure we're all on the same page. We're looking at the inventory. Okay, loading now, beautiful. And what we're selecting is as I hover over each of these, you can sort of see that each one of these is kind of the information. We wanna go through all of them, okay? So what we've actually gone and done is we've got 10 listings, which is good to know. So we've got this thing called listings, and a listing is equal to listing zero. So you can easily make that one and it will go to the next and there's up to 10 in there. So what we're doing is we're creating an empty dictionary. We're grabbing all this stuff. Oh, and you've done it here. Okay, listing color. Oh, you've gone right in there. Okay. Oh, you've gone way further ahead than I thought you would have. Didn't even know that was available. What? Okay, I need to further understand this. What have you done? Okay, let's just run this thing. Okay, running. Okay. So all that's in there. No way. Oh yeah. Where's color? Oh. Well, I never. Okay. Let's just have. Oh wow. Okay, you've done it this way. So this is a cool way. So you've created a variable. You found a variable. Okay, so you got mileage data, which is that guy. And then listing mileage strip equals that. And then listing mileage equals integer of this. Oh, good. Yeah, this is good code. This is good code. Did you write this? This is good code. I like this. You're selecting the bigger bit and then getting down. It's actually really easy to read. I like that. One risk we'll always run into is if things move around or for whatever reason it's not there, you get an error, but that's cool. We can work through fixing that. Transmission, it's on its own. Stock number, price data. So what I'm doing here is I'm just chucking in some extra spaces, and maybe what we'll do is we'll just put stuff in here like, whoop. And this is just me being a bit pedantic about it, but mileage, okay. We won't bother doing the whole thing. All right, price, good. And then you just, yeah, beautiful. Okay, this is looking really nice. So, in fact, taking that out. What we're gonna do now is we're gonna take that, cut that, put that there. First thing we're gonna test is, because if you recall, we had, did you do link as well? Just me, no, just me. Okay, so we did bum, bum, bum. So this is kind of all of it, right? This is us just doing all the things. We're getting, you know, link, all that stuff. So this guy here sets it to, if we just put this up a tiny bit more, ultimately this cell here kind of does all the stuff to fill this dictionary. So the way to test that is run that cell, and we're gonna go ahead and do that. It's empty, which is good. We're going to do that, and then we're going to do that, and now it's full, which is beautiful. So we've got image URL, listing link, perfect, listing title, listing color, ooh, listing mileage, none, listing transmission, 7-speed Porsche, can't even, no, listing stock number, ripper, and listing price, and you've got that there set with a little good. All right, so it's actually quite simple. So just to test everything's gonna work, let's jump into the next item in the listing. Cool, that one works. And so I'm pretty comfortable with that. So why don't we package this up into a little function, which is kind of cool. And we'll call it define, we'll say like, you know, call it the car dict. And what that's gonna look like is, if you think about it, what we're going to pass in there is kind of almost like, so we've got listing dictionaries, this our listing, right? And we've used our listing all the way through this. We'll pass in our listing, and that's fine. So we'll run that. Cool. And then, so what that's going to look like is we're going to go to our listing. It's going to basically say, hey, when this function kicks off, it's going to have an empty dictionary, and by the end of it, it's going to return, bum bada bum bum, it's going to return that dictionary. So to test that, what we can do is we don't need that. Do we need that? What was that? Listing? No, we don't need that. We don't need that. Okay, so what we can say is this is an example of a listing, so we can do car dict. Okay, and we can chuck that in there, and it returns that, which is really nice. Pick a random number, 7. Cool, returns that. It's a different one again. And finally, just make sure we're not... Okay, it looks really good. Cool. So what we've done now is we've packaged up the ability to generate a dictionary on one of the listings. And we have lots of listings, and they're all there. So what we're going to do, and this is so simple, you'd be like, wow, that was so simple. We're going to chuck this guy up here. Okay, so that generates the dictionary. This is our listing. So for a listing in listings, okay, we are going to go ahead and generate a dictionary. Okay, but and that's basically one listing, right? So what the, I guess not the problem, but the challenge we're going to have is if this runs, it will just keep generating a dictionary. So we kind of need to put that somewhere. So we'll chuck all those dictionaries in a list. And I'm just going to call it master list is equal to a blank list, which is that guy there. And we're going to go ahead and append that. So what we're actually doing here is if you have a look, we are saying, whoop, we're going, remember, master list is nothing. It's an empty list. And then for a listing in listings, because we've got listings here, which is selecting all 10 on the page, listing equals the car dict, and in master list, we're going to append this listing, which is good. So remember, our listing is that big chunk of HTML. We're passing that over to car dict, which so we need to put that in there. And we're assigning that to a variable called listing, and then we're going to add it to our master list. So what that might look like is you run that, and it failed. Listings is not defined. Okay, let's figure out what I've done here in listings. Oh, in listing. Okay, that makes sense. Okay, ran that time. So you'll find more and more, the better you get at Python, the less big errors you get and more silly errors due to extra letters and all the rest of it. So now if we look at master list, we have a list of dictionaries, which lends themselves really well to creating a data frame. So in this part, we are going to create a data frame just to show how easy it is to create, you know, once you've got a list of dictionaries, how that can be converted into a data frame. And then we're going to jump back into actually going ahead and trying to scrape every single page for those 10 listings. Ideally, if I can crank it up to 50 or 100 listings per page, that'll make things a lot easier as well. So how do we do that? So we've got to make sure we have imported pandas as PD, and I'll actually just chuck that right at the top. So I'll put that one up here and run that. And then the data frame is as simple as PD. I know this one, data frame, and we're going to make it from the master list. Run that, run df, beautiful. So we have image URL, listing color, listing display price, listing link, that's good. So image URL, listing link, listing mileage, all 0. Stock number, this one's missing a stock number. We can check the website why, you know, number 3 and number 10's missing. We'll just do that now. So we've got number 1, 2, 3. Yep, it's missing there, and I think the last one's missing as well. Beautiful. Okay, that's actually really good. So this confirms that data's right. It's just missing data on the web page. We'll just quickly spot check 184. So expensive. 184,830. And where's the price? 184,830,660. Yeah, I'm pretty happy with that. You've done a really good job. And the other cool thing is, as you recall, DF, you can just do tot to CSV. Give it a name. So sample output.csv, I don't want the index, so index is equal to false. Cool. So now when we have a look at that, we can go Python for Scott, sample CSV, and it's that quick. We now have a really nice scrape data. We can sort of see all the data we need to see here. Cool. So that's done. So now what we need to do is we need to figure out a way of how do we actually go ahead, and if you scroll here, how do we go ahead and just skip through these pages, per page 1, page 2, page 3, and how do we know we get to the end? So there's a couple of different ways to do that. In this example, we'll probably just say, hey, look, it just keeps going. Now, I want to know where the page does end, because what we can do is we can set up some smarts that's basically a true or false statement. And this is good because these ones start having mileage. Okay, so this page is going for a while. In the top here, we've got page 7. Let's just have a bit of a play and see how far we can go. Actually, take that all back. I can see here there's double, All right, 29 pages. Perfect. Okay. So it looks like 29 is the final page. So which tells me if I go to page 30, okay, I should get an error or something should basically, okay, nothing's returned. Beautiful. Okay. So what that means is when I do that find all, it won't find it all. It will find nothing. So there is no results filter. Okay, great. So for now, what we're going to do is we're going to just work and build a thing that grabs the first 20 pages. Once we're comfortable that's working, it's generating the final output, we'll go back and we'll figure out some smarts about how does it know when it gets to the end. And that's the secret to any sort of program. Just take it one step at a time, iterate through it, we'll figure it out. So back to our web scraping. Let me just close this one up here. Okay, back to our web scraping. Okay, so what do we need to do? We've packaged up this little guy, which is good. And we're basically parsing in what we need to parse in to do that. But ultimately what we need to do is we need to actually iterate through this guy as well. So what we might have to do is we might have to actually chuck these all on the same line. So let's go ahead and do that. Don't put it there twice. So soup. So this guy can sit way up here, right? So this is like a function. It doesn't do anything until it's called. So you can have complete rubbish. Well, not like that, but you can have complete rubbish in there and it won't fail until you call upon that function. So that's why it's okay to have a whole bunch of logic of something that doesn't really exist until later, because it's not really being run until later. And then later you'll have a listing available. So let's go ahead and have a play around with this. So let's do this. So this master list is really important. We want to keep that out of the loop, because if you think about the master list, what it's doing is each time it's being called or created, it's creating an empty list. Now, if you create an empty list at the start of page one and then go to page two, create an empty list and then fill that with page two, by the time you get to page 29, you'll just have 29. The 29th page wouldn't have all the other pages. So keep that in mind. Whew, all right, so getting excited. Okay, so we don't really need this data frame stuff's not that important. What is important though, that we can actually modify this number. Right now it's number one, and it's currently a string, so it's really important we pass that through as a string. So what we might do is, if you're familiar with creating a range, so if you look at for x, or I prefer I in range, okay, and you start from say one to get to 20, you go to 21. And let me just get this right, so print I. You can see here 1 through to 20, so it starts at 1, goes all the way up to 21, so not 21. So what we'll do is we'll be using this bit of logic for I in range just for now, because it's a quick scraping job, we'll get the job done, but then we'll put some smarts in later to be able to determine when the page is actually complete, when there's no more listings. So let's walk through this. So we've got headers, we've got the master list. For I in range 1 to 21, okay. And what we're going to do is we're going to bring these over. So tab, and you shouldn't use tab, you should use four spaces, but it's a lot easier to use tab. And what we're going to do here is we're going to get rid of this one. And we're not just going to put I, because I is a number and you can't, you probably could, but it's not ideal. So you want to basically cast it as a string and put that one there. And I kind of want to know this thing's running. Hey, so like print getting page, and then we'll put, let's go here. String I. Okay, we'll give that a red hot shift enter. So getting page one, getting page two, getting page three. I'm not going to keep talking. Fast forward. Done. Okay, so we've got our 20 pages. Whether or not that worked is really down to some checks and balances. So let's have a look and just see out of our, so we've got a master list, right? So let's have a look at the length of that. Now each, there was 10 per page from memory, and cool. So apparently it's 200 items in that master list. And our DF, so same logic as before. Let's have a look at that output now. Okay, ripper. So from what I could tell, we now have all 200 listings. Awesome. Okay, so far so good. Pretty easy. If this was a once-off scraping job, you can literally just set your range to how many pages you know are in this website. But that's not always the case. Sometimes you will want to do this every day, week, or month, and you want to have a variable number of pages available to you. So this is part two. Scott, homework for part three. I need you to build a function that will determine whether or not you should continue scraping. Get to it.